gentlemen, welcome to the Godolphin School Music Competition Final. It's a great honour to welcome Simon McHenry, who's going to adjudicate for us tonight. I don't think we hit him in the slightest. And it's really great that he's able to come and do this. It's lovely to see so many of you here. Girls, you've already won, so enjoy yourselves and go for it. Okay? We'll do grade 1 to 3, and then adjudicate, grade 4 to 5, then adjudicate, grade 5 to 6 to 8, then adjudicate, and then we'll give the prizes at the end, and I'll give you time just to calculate the house cup. I do know approximately, I know what the numbers are for now, but extra points awarded, of course, for the overall winners this evening. I can tell you that at the moment, Douglas are in a lead, Methu behind, Hamilton a little way behind.
Good, really enjoyed that. It was also really nice and rhythmic and very confident.
good posture. He stood there nice and confident and played it really, really well. I enjoyed that very much indeed. And lastly, Kara, Kyra. Okay, that block, it's a tricky piece, so you did really well. I enjoyed it a lot. And there was a nice even tone throughout most of it. You might want to just try a little bit more dynamic contrast in there. You started quite enthusiastically and quite quickly. And it's quite good sometimes to give yourself just a moment to sort of take a breath, just kind of think, right, okay, here we go, and then start. But I really liked it, and as I said, really tricky piece that you managed really well. But I've got to choose one winner from the three of you. So I'm going to choose Amelia for the really confident performance.
And anyhow. But I really loved it, and also I really loved the way that you brought out the tune. It was really beautifully and melodic and as I said, nicely sensitive. Very enjoyable. So she used to be my waitress, Olivia. I really, really enjoyed it. I mean, I thought, first of all, I mean, it's quite a challenging song. Do you mind if I ask how old you are? 15. It's a challenging song for a 15-year-old, I would say. And it's got, you know, quite a lot of technical stuff going on. And I thought you really, you know, kind of shone doing that. I've worked on it with a couple of students myself, and I had to say to several people, it's not your song because it goes too low. And you really managed those low notes. I really enjoyed those. But most of all, what I loved most was the way you communicated the song. It felt like you meant every word that you sang. And you brought those words across really well. So, I mean, as time wears on, and as you get a bit older, did you think about the sound you produce at the top of your voice and how you're going to go about it and to get something maybe quite theatrical in the sound? But I just thought it was a really confident and accomplished performance. Really, really enjoyable. Oh, I've got one more thing for you, which is just a complete nightmare for singers. What to do with your hands? You have a thing with your right hand that you don't know what to do with it. I noticed, good luck with it. Think of something to do with your right hand. It's a pain for a singer. I mean, being a bloke, I used to do all my singing lessons like this, because it just saves an awful lot of grief, but you can't sing like that in a performance, sadly. So just toy with what you do with your right hand. But I loved it, really good. Cool. Over the Hills and Far Away, another Olivia. Jaunty and rhythmic. Splendid. And for the most part, some really nice tone. A few bits where that just kind of wandered ever so slightly, but that's okay. I love that first section. Yes, it had some nice rhythmic qualities to it. And then when you moved on to the slow section, the contrast was really nice and was more sensitive. There were a few slips here and there, a few little rhythmic moments where you kind of weren't quite on top of it. But it was a good, accomplished performance, and I really enjoyed it. And I guess probably a thing that I might look for is because you're already facing the audience, you might occasionally just get your eyes out of the music just to give us a little kind of eyeball here and there. But I really enjoyed it. Really nice. Good. Hedvig's thing. A tricky piece. Some of those interesting little chromatic notes just hanging around in there. And almost all of them, you really nailed it. The old note was just slightly wonky. But it's tricky to get all of those notes, and it's always tricky on a cello. I never know how cellists play the cello because it seems too clever for me. But I really like that. And it was also a very nice rhythmic kind of enjoyable piece. Again, you might, with a piece, particularly with a piece like that is kind of very filming, obviously. You might want to just think about kind of bringing us in to your performance a little bit more. It's obviously a bit easier for a singer if she decides to put her music down and just sort of sing, then her eyes are already up here, so it's almost cheating. But for those of you who are looking at your music, absolutely fine, of course. But just every now and then, just kind of bring us in to what you're doing. So you might have guessed who I'm going to give the prize to for this. So for me, the best performance of the four of you, though I loved all four of you, was indeed, now I'll get right, Olivia Lloyd. So well done.
Well, thank you very much, and let's head on now to the grade 6 to 8. Thank you. Thank you.
Can we have a huge round of applause? Brilliantly. I'm sure you probably think I will always say this, but actually this is the best competition like final I've heard. This is about the fifth time we've done this. I think that is the best final. So well done, girls. Absolutely amazing. Rather you than me, so I have to say. But we'll hand over to you.
Absolutely right. I mean, well, I'm hoping that while I witter on for a bit, that I might be able to make my mic up. Well, before I do that, I just want to also thank everyone for being here, because, I mean, I know it was a very long time ago, but I do vaguely remember what it was like to be a young musician. It's just wonderful to have encouragement from people around you, and to feel supported, and to feel that people really want you to do well. So just thank you for your support for being here. That's terrific for a start. Also, yes, thank you for a wonderful piano playing. Terrific. Really good. Okay. Right. Well, I mean, they were just four extraordinary, wonderful, accomplished performances. I mean, really terrific. So, Ellie, first. Hi. I mean that Massenet, obviously, it's a famous tune, and it's a lovely tune, and it's almost asking for trouble playing it, because everyone goes, oh yeah, I like this. And so it really demands that you play sensitively and with lots of legato, and all of those things that everyone wants to bring to a piece of music, and you did. So that's really terrific. Some lovely kind of sensitive playing through the lines, some lovely pulling up just here and there, really nice. I'm no technician on the flute, but I mean, it looked to me that you were doing an awful lot of tricky stuff, making it look jolly easy, which is fantastic. Also, you were very communicative with your pianist, which I loved to see. There were little moments where you just looked over and just kind of, and we'll do this now, which is really, really nice to see. I really enjoyed it. Fantastic breathing. Really good. Really terrific. What else? Some lovely dynamic contrast in there as well. It was engaging, but it was mostly engaging because I really got a sense from you that you enjoyed playing it, which is nice. Really like that. Okay. Iris, the four of you, just astonishing. I mean, who turns up at a thing like this and sings piano? I mean, that's just, it's just so difficult. It's so difficult. From the get-go, your performance is really dramatic. Opera is obviously my world, and so I just love to see a singer give a really good dramatic performance. Sometimes, you know, with younger performers, you kind of know that they want to do something dramatic with it. So they turn on the drama, but you get something like a one-note performance in terms of the drama. But yours was up and down and all over the shop, and it was kind of miserable, and then it was angry, and then it was desperate, and just the works in there. So, I mean, that's already a good start. It helps if you have some decent technique and a nice voice to start with to sing something like that. Oh, well, that's not a problem. I mean, it just had luscious tone all over it, and some really good technique. It's an impossible thing to breathe, that piece. And I was busy. I'm afraid I cursed fate with my writing here, because I just wrote down, oh, amazing breathing, just before you took two breaths, really. Never mind. It was really, really classy. What else have I written here? I mean, unbelievably communicative, of course. I mean, really good. Lovely legato, lovely phrasing. Just some of those top notes, just beautifully ringing. Wonderful facial expressions. Terrific coloratura in that middle section. Just really good. I love the decorations in your recapitulation. Really nice. Yeah, it's a beautiful line. Lovely legato line. Really good. The one or two places where you just force the sound a little. And I think it's another young singer thing that, you know, you want to really produce the goose. And sometimes you kind of think, right, I should be making a bit more of a kind of now. And sometimes you just push it a little bit too much. Don't do that. Don't do that. But Hammond is just phenomenal. So, I mean, every time someone played, I thought, oh, well, this is easy. And you're going to tick, lovely, yes, you're going to get a prize. So then we move on to Olivia. And I kind of thought, I mean, piano, presumably, you know, she's a singer. And then she also, you know, dabbles a bit at the piano. Really, that's just the most ridiculous piece. It's just unbelievably fiendish. Just fiendish. All the rhythmic stuff at the beginning. I've got rhythmic stuff on the way through. I'm just really fiendish, and you just look like complete natural. I don't know how long you have spent practicing that piece. I mean, for anyone who's sitting here thinking, oh yeah, I'm just going to do my practice. hours and hours and hours you must have spent doing that, which I just admire so much. Just fantastic. I just written down, oh, well played. I was so articulate, loads of wonderful dynamic contrast. But the thing I also loved was you brought an emotional depth to your performance. It was mature and it was sensitive and it was intelligent. And I really love that. And I think, you know, for someone so young, it's just really amazing, really amazing. A bravura performance I've written down. There were a couple of tiny errors. On at least one of those, I saw your face go, and just never do that. Look proud of your mistakes. Very important. And it was passionate, and it was committed, and it was wonderfully communicative. I just thought, extraordinary, wonderful. And then I kind of thought, oh, you're a poor old woman, she's just going to have to. That's a piece of art as well. But from the get-go, the tone you produced was so beautifully lyrical and just lovely, lovely sounds you get out of that instrument. It's just really beautiful. And again, just a real sensitivity, wonderfully communicative. And again, you really responded to the piece and felt like you just loved that piece and enjoyed playing it and wanted to share it with us, which is terrific. And again, I mean, I don't know that much about playing. I mean, my grade 4 viola is not going to be very fun. But, you know, I mean, I know that all that double stopping that you were doing on there is not the work of a moment. I mean, that's really impressive, particularly, you know, going up into all that crazy high stuff. I mean, just amazing. Really wonderfully technical. Again, useful legato in there. And it was charming. I've written down a performance full of charm and charisma, which is great. It was something just that I can't imagine anyone not just really loving that performance. Oh God, I got to the end of my notes. Well, if I could, I would just give you all. I'm not allowed to give them all the prize. So, I think just because it was so difficult and done with so much commitment and so intelligently and emotionally performed, I'm sorry to do this. It's a second cup for Olivia Lloyd.
do my imposing on. Thank you very much indeed.